Hi, Gaylerd here. Hey, welcome back to the Big Dawg Challenge. In this lesson, I'm going to show you the typical notes that I use to make transitions from the E minor to the A minor to the C to the D and to the G. Now, what's cool is that they're the same notes, but it's the way that you use those notes to transition to the chord that you're going to find interesting on this, I think. And hey, this is a great lesson for you to learn. It's really helpful when you want to transition to between chords. And so here I go talking like this. Let's just get into it. I think you're going to like this. It's not going to be too difficult for you to learn, just a lot of finger movements, but this is what Big Dawg Guitar is all about. Meet me in the studio. Okay, now let me show you the notes, the typical notes that I use when I'm playing an E minor when I transition to the different basic open chords. Now, these are the basic notes that I use. On an E minor, you've got a lot of notes in here that you can choose from. And remember this, I'm going to show you the notes on the tab. Let me just show it to you right now, and then I'm going to explain it to you how we use these notes. Here's the notes we're going to be using, and we're going to use, I'm just telling you right now, we can use any pattern, any progression of these notes. But here's the notes. Got an open 6, 2 on 6, 3 on 6, open 5, 2 on 5, 3 on 5. Remember, these are not scales, right? Open 4, 2 on 4, open 3, 2 on 3, open 2, 1 on 2, 2 on 2, and open 1. Now, sometimes when I'm playing that, I'm going to take my pinky and I'm going to use that third fret on that first string. I'm going to play that G note. I'm going to use that in there, but it's typically not one that I'm going to use, but you can use that in there to transition to a chord. Now, here's what you want to know. When you transition, you can use any of those notes in any pattern to transition to a chord, as long as when you hit your chord that you're going to, we're going to go to a C. We're going to go from the E minor. In fact, I'll tell you, we're going to go to an A minor. That'll be the easiest. I'm going to go from the E minor to an A minor. And you can use any notes as long as when you hit your chord, you are hitting the bass note of the chord. So when you go to an A minor, the bass note is that A string, the open 5. So no matter what notes we play out of that tab, when we hit that A chord, we got to make sure that we're hitting the open 5. So here's what I'm talking about. I'm just going to use some of these basic notes down here on the 5-4. Let's see, 6, 5, and 4 strings, and I'm going to wind up hitting that open 5. Okay, so here's what we want to do. I'm going to show you, I'm going to give you an example of this, and what I'm going to do is I'm going to start playing the E minor, and we're going to go to an A minor, okay? So I can hit any progression of notes as long as when I hit that A minor, my first note is the open 5, the A string, okay? So I'm going to show you a little bit, I'm going to show you a quick example of what I'm talking about. And what I'm going to do is I'm just going to use a few notes on the 5th, 4th, and 3rd string to do a transition, a little run, and then I'm going to wind up, when I hit that A chord, I'm going to wind up hitting that open 5. So it'd be like this. Goes. So the note that I'm actually hitting, here's that little run I'm doing. Okay? And that note right there is that A. Now, I could have very well started with an open 1 string, just like that, like this. And what I'm doing now in these sessions to show you, once I go to a chord, I'm just going to use basically the same notes that I'm using in the E chord to get back to it. So if I'm in an A, I'm just going to use those same notes that I showed you in your tab to get back to the A. Now, once you're changing chords and you know notes to use in the A minor, you can use those notes to get back to the E minor, okay? So here we go. Let me try this again. Thank you. okay? Well, I like to do slides, and there's that slide I was telling you about. You can go up here and catch that E note, which is your open one. Just do a little slide with your ring finger or your pinky. Okay, as long as you hit that open, it doesn't matter what you do. Any pattern of those notes. Okay, now let's go from an E minor, let's go to a C chord. Now let's go from the E minor to the D minor. Okay, so it'd be like this. And now the D minor, we need to open that open four string. Any of those notes, any pattern of notes, to get to the next chord, as long as you hit that bass note of the chord. Let's try going to a B minor. If you were to go to a B minor, there's your bass note is the B, so it's the second fret on the fifth string. So now when you do this, you've got to make sure that you get your index finger planted down on that note strong enough to where you hear it, okay? So let's try that. We'll do it a little bit slower. Hear it? You gotta make sure that you get into that note. Okay. Okay. So there's your B minor. Let's say that you were going to an F. Okay, let's try the E minor going to an F. Now when you hit that F, you gotta make sure that we're hitting that first string on that the first fret on a sixth string to get that F chord. So you wanna make sure when you're hitting that you're prominent down on this lower register, okay? So here we go. I'll start out with an E. Now here we go to an F. And there, all I did there is I kept my chord formation and I just plucked down on a string. You can do that too. Or just go up, down, pick random notes, anything you want to do in there as long as you hit that note that you're going to. Since we're from an F and I'm going down to the E, I got to make sure that I'm hitting that bottom E string. So that's all there is to those transitions. You can transition to any chord. So here's what I want you to do. I want you to transition from the E minor using all of those notes, any pattern that you want to. You can use any pattern as long as you're using those notes that I showed you. If you want to embellish and use another note that wasn't in there, try it out. I didn't tell you to use that note, but it might sound good. You can use it. If it sounds good, keep it in. If it doesn't, throw it out. So I want you to transition from the E minor to an A minor and back. I want you to transition E minor to F, okay, and back. E minor to G and back. E minor to D minor and back. And E minor to D. And E minor to A. You've got to learn all of these chords because you never know when it's going to come up in a song, right? So we need to be able to make sure that we know those notes to use and that we're getting to the bass note of the chord. Now, here's the thing. When you do that, remember there's going to be different beats. So I'm using one beat for you, but it will be the same no matter what the beat of the song is. The theory is the same. You're always going to, no matter how many notes you hit, you always want to wind up with that bass note of the chord that you're going to. So practice that. Make sure that you get it smooth before you try and move on, because if you're not able to do it yet, it's going to be tougher as we move on to these other chords. So get the A minor, and then we're going to do the E minor, and then we're going to move on to the A minor chord, and you're going to learn how to do that one too. So go ahead and start practicing. And I'll see you back in the studio.